Hi, welcome to Entertainment TV World. There are several ways to earn online, but these are the most profitable work one can do online. If you're in college and want to work but have trouble finding the time, these online jobs for students to earn money can give you the flexibility you're looking for. Not to mention, working online often pays way better than your regular campus positions. Double win. 1. Social Media Manager. What it pays, $15.40/hour. Most of us spend hours a week on social media anyway. Why not get paid for it? Every business uses social media, but managing it in-house is more expensive, employee taxes, and employees' time is better spent elsewhere. That's where independently contracted social media managers come in. Social media managers help build brand awareness by curating content, building relationships with potential customers, and driving new leads. Your job is to be the online voice of the company. Get started as a social media manager by approaching local businesses and telling them about your services. Start by reaching out to businesses you already frequent: yoga studios, coffee shops, boutiques, restaurants, etc. Focus on whatever social media platforms you're most comfortable with, and talk about how you can use it to grow their business and reach new customers. 2. Blogger. What it pays, varies. Some bloggers make $100,000 plus per month. If I could go back in time, I would for sure have started a blog in college. As a finance major, I could have used the creative outlet. The key to making money as a blogger is to write content that provides value to your readers. No one wants to read an article titled "My Family Vacation to Hawaii," except maybe your mom and Aunt Jody. On the other hand, a piece on 7 things you need to know before vacationing in Hawaii is both intriguing and helpful. Before you start your blog, choose a topic you enjoy writing about, and make it specific. As they say in marketing, if you speak to everyone, you'll speak to no one. Once you have your topic, write down at least 20 blog post ideas, then get to cracking on your first 5 posts. This is a good test of whether or not you actually enjoy writing on your chosen subject, or even at all. Once you're ready to start your blog, the next step is to choose a host for your website. HostGator is a popular option and the one we recommend for beginner bloggers. It's not free, plans start at $2.75 per month, but it's an essential first step. See our step-by-step guide to starting a profitable blog to kick things off on the right foot. Related, learn how this new mom is making serious money with her blog. 3. Freelance Writer. What it pays, $50-$500 plus per article. Don't sweat your credentials here. If you have good grammatical skills and a desire to write, you can make it as a freelance writer. Just ask Holly Johnson. She went from working in a mortuary to making over $200,000 per year as a freelance writer. You read that right, $200,000. Freelance writing is a flexible and lucrative way to make money in college. And think how cool it would be to add to your resume published in the New York Times or some other big media outlet. Having an online presence in the form of your own blog can help you land high-paying clients faster and serve as a portfolio for your work. Otherwise, you can get started as a freelance writer by picking up clients on Upwork. Once you've got some work to show and testimonials to back you up, start pitching to jobs on Problogger and freelance writing jobs. See also, how to get paid to write, 10 websites that pay for content. 4. Virtual Assistant. What it pays, $15-$200 plus per hour. Virtual assistant services range from data entry and customer service to copywriting and email marketing. The amount you can charge as a virtual assistant depends on your skill set and experience. Specialized skills like copywriting or email marketing are premium services that pay premium rates. Businesses hire virtual assistants to outsource tasks that don't need to be done in-house. For example, a cafe makes food, keeps the dining and kitchen areas clean, and serves customers. They don't specialize in social media management or content marketing. By hiring a virtual assistant, they can avoid paying employee taxes, since VAs aren't employees of the businesses they work for, and have someone experienced managing their digital marketing efforts. It's a win-win. Start working as a virtual assistant by making a list of services you can offer. Then create profiles on Zirtual and Virtual Assistant Networking to start booking your first clients. For more information, see our guide on the exact steps to become a virtual assistant.